Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to look at differentiation from the position of superiority. You are never going to be able to do that unless you tell your stories about how you've helped, about how you continue to help. And if I had time, I would go around this room and I'd find out some stories. And I'd learn that you have saved millions in this room. You have saved jobs. You've created new opportunities. That's in this room. I know it is. It's in every room I ever go to. But we don't often communicate those. So, we have a sleep. Tom can now sleep for the first time in years. And because the baby's on the way, you better enjoy that. It's not going to last very long. Okay. So, in part three now, in the last few minutes that we have, I ask you to find your Toms. Please, could you join me in the following little exercise? We have here, let me get this up here. I'm going to look at for nods or shakes of heads here for consensus. Is it fair to say, ladies and gentlemen, that if we have a client who has a high perceived value of us, of what we do, but doesn't feel like they're paying a lot of money to get it, they're actually getting it on the cheap, that we're leaving money on the table with that client? Is that fair to say? I've got enough nods there to do that. Okay, if they have a low perceived fee, we're not paying much, and we're not getting much for it either, this is a grade C client or worse for us. Fair to say? Okay. If we have a high perceived value, we're getting a lot from our firm, but we're also paying top dollar for it, I would assume we've got a grade A client. Is that correct? Okay, and therefore, if we have a high perceived fee, we're paying you a lot of money, but we're getting low perceived value, we don't really understand what we're getting for this money, we have a client vulnerable to attack. Yes? Okay, show of hands, please, very quickly, just for your opinions. Okay, hands up if you think that you have got roughly 30% or more in that grade A client bracket in your firms. Do you have more than 30% of your entire portfolio that you class as grade A? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, maybe 13, roughly speaking. I will therefore assume that the rest of us has less than 30% in our grade A. So if we've got, let's say, between 30 and 50%, let's say, in our grade A category, that means that we've got somewhere between 50 and 70% who are in that red one there, vulnerable to attack. Yeah? That's why we need a pipeline. So, here are our 7 lost avenues. I would ask you now just to take a couple of minutes to see if you could jot down a name, please, of one business that might come to mind in each of those 7 areas. So, what proposals have you lost that you wish you had won? Do you remember the name of anybody that you talked to, the name of the business? Can you just jot down one for me, please? That's all I ask. Just try and grab one of those, or if you have a tablet, to get them on your tablet. A client that you'd want back, just one, please. And so on down the list. And I'd like you, by those names, to put a value by it, a value of what you think it would be worth if you won the ex-client back, a value think of what you think it would be worth to the firm if the lost proposal became an accepted proposal, or if you made a new center of influence, what they could perhaps refer to you first time round. If I could just ask you just to try and jot down one name in each category and one value beside each of the ones you can think of, and in just a minute or so, I'm going to come to you and ask what our total figures are of opportunity done on such a summary basis. So just 2 or 3 hands, please, because I am now short of time. Just 2 or 3 hands, please, on what total we managed to find just in that very, very straightforward exercise. Any totals arrived yet? Sir? Quarter of a million, thank you.
Yeah, 280.
Yeah, 280, thank you. We're around about 500,000 already. Anybody else? One more is great, please. About 215? I mean, about 300. Yeah, why not? Let's be above everybody else. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, if this was a workshop session, I'd have asked you to do 3 in each of those categories and the values, and this room would have produced well over $10 million without breaking a sweat. It is never lower than 1.5, no matter what room, size of room I'm in. And I think my estimate will be conservative at 10 million. Huge opportunity that we haven't got to do any marketing towards yet. They're already on the doorstep in one form or other.